How do I use an unallocated space partition? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Every once in a while, you'll get a new machine or find on your existing machine that your partitions are laid out in such a way that there's actually a small or perhaps not so small partition that is there but unused. Let me show you what that looks like and then show you how to use it. So here we are in Windows 11. The thing to do, of course, is right-click on the Start menu and then click on Disk Management. That will show you all of the disks you have on your system and the partitions that they happen to have. I'll go ahead and make this a little bit bigger so we can see more of it. You'll see that there's a disk that happens to contain drive F, but it also has this 10 gigabytes unallocated space at the end of it. That's space that's there on your hard disk, but there's no way to use it the way things are configured right now. There are two approaches to making use of that space. I'm going to talk about one and show you the other one that I recommend you use. So one approach is to create a standalone drive out of the 10 gigabytes. We'd right-click on it, we'll go New Simple Volume, hit Next, go ahead and use all of the space. In other words, we're using the maximum space available there. We'll go ahead and assign it a drive letter when we're done, and then we'll format it with NTFS. What this will do, I'm actually not going to do it because this is typically not the approach I recommend, but what this will do is it will turn this 10 gigabytes into its own drive. As we've seen, it'll be drive H. Drive H will be 10 gigabytes in size, and you can use it for whatever you like to do. As I said, this isn't typically what I recommend. It can be useful in some cases, especially if the criteria for what I recommend aren't being met, but it is an option. So, what do I recommend instead? Well, in this case, what I'd rather like to do is basically add that space to my F drive. Now, that works in Windows because this unallocated space is immediately following the F drive. If it's not immediately following, then you need to take different steps. You can either create a drive out of that unallocated space, as we just talked about, or you might need to use a third-party tool to rearrange the partitions. But in this case, since that unallocated space is immediately following my F drive, I can just make F bigger. I'll right-click on it and click on Extend Volume. Click on Next. We've selected the partition that follows it, the 10 gigabyte partition, to be added to the drive. We'll click Next. This is what we're going to do. And we'll click Finish. Boom. And it really is that fast. Now, the unallocated space is gone, but my F drive is 10 gigabytes bigger. If you have unallocated space on your hard drive, this might be something you want to consider doing. As I said, the criteria for being able to add it to an existing partition is that the unallocated space needs to follow that partition. If not, then you are in fact looking at third-party tools to actually move the partitions around. The Windows Disk Manager does not support that kind of operation, but there are other tools out there that do. Because this is partition management, regardless of whether you're doing this yourself using Disk Manager or using a third-party tool, naturally, I strongly recommend your actual first step be a full image backup. Hope that's helpful. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/4895. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.